one of the most striking symptoms of addiction of all kinds is the loss of judgment. People do things that they never would have done before they became addicted, and this applies to everyone, whether it's a doctor, a lawyer, a well-educated person, or someone who's a grammar school dropout. Once they become addicted, they take all kinds of risk. Now, what's relevant to HIV is that they take risky sex, they trade drugs for sex, they exchange needles, they use other people's needles, and they inject themselves with stuff that would make you sick, actually. But it's because of the loss of judgment. So this is one of the symptoms of addiction that I think doesn't get as much publicity as it should. And this means that and the reason I'm giving you this background is that it's not just heroin addiction. It's alcoholism, it's cocaine, it's amphetamine, it's barbiturates and benzodiazepines, all of these drugs that people use and become hooked. By that I mean they're no longer in control. The drug is in control. And they lose their better judgment, and they do all sorts of things that is terrible for their health, and that's how they spread disease. My experience with opiate addiction goes back to my time in the United States Navy when I was a medical officer charged with taking care of Marines and Navy men who were fighting in Vietnam. This was during the Vietnam War. And when they would come back to my ward in Philadelphia, they were still in withdrawal from the heroin they had been using in Vietnam. And we had no good medications to treat heroin addiction at that time. Methadone was just being developed. So there was a kind of a crash program of setting up methadone programs all over the United States, and I started one of the first ones in 1971 in Philadelphia. And then later, we started studying naltrexone. Now, naltrexone at that time was considered to be the perfect antidote because it's a medication that completely blocks the effects of heroin, but it's not addicting in itself. And we all thought that was going to be the perfect medication. It turned out that in the oral version of naltrexone, hardly any addicts wanted to try it. And when they did try it, they didn't like it because it worked too well. They became completely unable to get high, and they missed that. And they asked to go back on methadone, or they just quit treatment altogether. So oral naltrexone, even though it got FDA approval, was never clinically effective, even though pharmacologically it was 100% effective. What's changed is that we realized that we needed a depot preparation, an injectable form of naltrexone, but the technology in the 1970s and 80s just wasn't there. In the 1990s, a company that had perfected a means of injecting drugs and having them dissolve slowly into the circulation so they could last a month or more was finally persuaded to try to develop and deliver naltrexone in this way, and that's what Vivitrol became, a depot form of naltrexone. So now that's what we're studying, and we're finding that it works extremely well, and the first placebo-controlled study has just been published. It was done in Russia. And that gave really wonderful results. The huge difference with the modern form of depot naltrexone is that on oral, the patient has to make a decision every day to take the medication, and their judgment is bad. They don't think about all the trouble that the addiction has gotten them into. They just think, well, gee, I'd really like to get high, and I miss getting high. So they just stop taking the medication, and they can relapse a few days later. With Vivitrol, it lasts for 4 weeks or more. So they only have to make the judgment once, And if you can just get them to come back for an injection every month, they're protected. And so far, it really seems to be working. My current study with this is in parolees, people with a history of heroin addiction who have just gotten out of prison. Normally what happens is that even though they're drug-free, within sometimes hours, and certainly within days or weeks, they get incredibly tempted to use heroin. They usually return to a neighborhood where heroin is freely available and relatively cheap, and the relapse rate after leaving prison is extremely high. We are now treating them with naltrexone shortly after they get out of prison, and it's working very well, and we have a very good record of the patients coming back every month to get the injection. We're doing the study in 5 cities in the United States, and our results so far are excellent.